I just look right there. Good afternoon. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Just wanted to first off by saying thank you. You know, thank you. I'm honored and blessed to be a part of this wonderful program with such rich tradition. Thankful to Coach O. Thankful to the athletic department, the administration, especially to the family of LSU. Just happy to be a part, happy to be back in the state of Louisiana. It's kind of like my second home. And look forward to what the future holds and how exciting it's going to be to be a Tiger this year. So at this point in time, if anyone has any questions.
Hey, Coach, good morning. My name is Michael Cobble. I work at the ABC TV station here in Baton Rouge, so we'll see a lot of you. Welcome back, as you said.
Thank you.
What intrigued you about this job? Why was it appealing to you, and what are you most anxious, I guess, to kind of sink your teeth into about it?
Well, the first thing is the prestige of LSU, right, as a whole, as a university, what it means to the community in Louisiana, you know, how it's a staple. You know, when I was here in Louisiana, I mean, everyone wanted to be a part of the program. And I love how the recruiting has put a fence around the state. And so that was very intriguing. And then to be a part of such tradition that they have here in terms of the defensive tradition, attacking style, overall, the playmakers that you're going to get from the state of Louisiana and the best around the country. So you have a chance to get the best players in the country, as you see it on this upcoming Sunday, right, with the Super Bowl participants. So that carries over. And then working with Coach O, you know, I look back to Coach O when, you know, he followed when he was at Ole Miss, and then I had a chance to visit with him when he was at USC, and you love his energy, you love being around him and what he brings to the table. And guys play to that, guys respond to that. And so just to be a part of that energy, the culture that he has built here, it was enticing. It was enticing.
Hey, Durante, Brooks Cabina from The Advocate. Ed Ogeron was just talking about how he wanted to be a little involved with the defense, and he talked to y'all about his vision. Whenever y'all were talking about the defense schematically, what is your vision for what LSU's defense is and what y'all will build here, what people will see?
Players first, scheme second. Right? Players first, scheme second. And so we want to put our guys in the best position to make plays. Right? We want to minimize error, make sure we're over-communicating, have an attacking-style defense where we can dictate the terms and play fast. You know, these guys are here for the athletic ability. We're going to give them some techniques and fundamentals, and we're going to harp on that. We're going to be very detailed in that. We're going to, like, you know, coaches have already probably talked to you about in terms of probably based out of a 4-3 because you have, you know, some studs on the outside with Ali Gay and you have Andre Anthony, those guys like that, that can set the edge and play fast. And so want to utilize their talents where they can be on the edge, play half a man, and disrupt the passing game. Also leading to that, to be very physical in the run game. The biggest thing that we want to do is do everything as violent as possible. And that's the aggressive mindset that we want to set forth going forward.
Hey, Coach, this is Shay Dixon with 24/7 Sports.
How's it going, Shay?
Congrats on
appreciate it.
Your job.
Appreciate
well. It. I was curious when you came, you know, when you got your interview and got to talk to Coach O, what was the thing that you really wanted to get across about who you were as a coach?
One, the ability to communicate. I think that's a strength that a coach has to have, you know, the ability to teach. You know, we're all teachers at the end of the day. And to command the room, to help guys understand and break this game down to its simplest format. And that's what I wanted to convey to Coach in terms of, on the interview, having the abilities to make this game easier in the thought process. And then also, like we just talked about, in terms of over-communicating, being a teacher, giving the guys the motivation to go out and put their best foot forward so that we can have a productive product on the field.
Hey, Coach Jones, this is Glenn West with LSU Country. Welcome aboard. I was just, you know, curious. You're also going to be coaching the safeties
yes.
You know, this year. I'm just curious as to what you see out of this secondary, what kind of improvements that can be made heading into this 2021 season, and then also your excitement level to get to work with Corey Raymond.
Oh, well, just in terms of the there's talent on the back end, I believe, especially with the safety position. Going forward, we want to be technique and fundamentally sound. We want to make sure our communication is clear and precise. making sure everyone's on the same page and working with Corey. I've known Corey for a couple of years, for quite a few years now, dating back to when we both were coaching high school ball here in Louisiana. So having that relationship, we've clinicked with each other over the years, and so we have some of the same beliefs. And so I think the transition would be much easier in that way. We'll be working together. And so when the safeties and corners are working together, it minimizes any miscommunications. And so I'm excited about the back end, being on the same page, minimizing the communication, working with Corey, working the press technique, working the safeties to be very physical in the run game, and also having some deep zone awareness and playmaking ability.
Hey, Durante, Brody Miller with The Athletic. How's it going?
Good.
I know you said, you know, players first, scheme second.
Yes.
But, I mean, you've been around so many schemes, been around so many coaches. I guess I'm curious what the process is for kind of building your own identity and schemes and philosophies.
Well, it's about the, you know, attitude reflects leadership, right? And so to be, you know, to be aggressive, you know, I think that's one of the key things. As long as we're fundamentally a technique sound, I know I keep harping on that, but that's football. You know, that's football, and everything else comes with it. You know, so you have to be having the right, you have to have the right technique. I know the fundamental, I know my assignment, I know what to do, and now I can go and execute what the coach is asking me to do. And so to me, that's just the identity of sound football, gap scheme, gap sound, everyone doing their 1/11th, doing their job, and that's what we can bring. That's what we have to bring. And then the ability to communicate. We have, again, I want to keep stressing the ability to over-communicate across the board on defense, because when you over-communicate, you minimize mental errors. And so that's the first thing we want to focus on, is minimizing the mistakes, minimizing any mental errors. Everyone's on the same page. And when everyone's on the same page and you're not thinking as much, then you can play fast and you can let your athleticism show. Because when you prepare, right, we want to talk about the preparation going into the game, preparing, focus, that breeds confidence, okay? Miscommunication, not having the proper preparation, not knowing how to break down film, not knowing what to look for on film as you study your opponent, that breeds stress, okay? And so we want more confidence and less stress when they're on the football field.
Hey, Durante, this is Garland Gillen out of Fox 8 in New Orleans. You're coming from the NFL, which is the top of the talent chain, but how appealing was it to come to LSU, because most of the kids you're going to be coaching are 4- and 5-star recruits that are all destined for the NFL. I mean, there's not that much of a drop-off from the pros of the LSU with this defense.
You know, that's a good point. We were talking about that the other day. When you look at our roster, and like you said, there's so many 4- and 5-star athletes on this roster, it's not the case, really, in the NFL when you get that. There's a lot of talent. There can be arguably more first-round picks or more first- and second-round draft picks on this ball club than in any NFL team. And so they just has to be developed, right? But the talent is there. If you look at the national championship team, you know, the amount of first rounders, I don't know too many NFL teams have 7 or 8 first rounders on their team, you know, just because of how you got to draft. So the talent is here. You know, I think the talent is here. The SEC West is like another division, right, at the end of the day of the National Football League. But we still have to develop the talent. You know, like you said, they come in as a 4- or 5-star athlete, but now it's our job to get them to play in and prepare and perform as a 4- and 5-star athlete.
Hey, Durante. My name is Jared Joseph, reporter with Fox 44 NBC 33 in Baton Rouge. Congratulations on getting the job.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. I was wondering, as a black man and coach host emphasis about making sure they have people who can relate to the players, what kind of relationship do you hope to build with this team, especially given the social injustice and environment that surrounded the team, especially what they went through last year? What kind of message and, I guess, moral compass do you hope to instill in the team when you build a bond with them?
That's a great question, especially with the climate that's going on in our country right now. My best answer to that is just to continue to be myself. And what I mean by that is I believe in building genuine relationships. And, you know, this business, we are in a relationship business. And what we do as coaches is building that trust factor, right? And so for a player to go out and want to lay it on the line for you, he's got to, one, be able to trust you. And do you have his best interest at heart? Can you relate to the person and not just the player? And I think that has been one of my goals as I go to each program or wherever I've been in the past, and just building that genuine relationship. Say, hey, man, I care about you. I care about your future. I care about life after football for you. I want to help you prepare to be not only the best team member that you could be, but be the best man that you can be so that you can develop into the community and be the best father that you can be, right? And so when that happens, when you have that, when you can help mold young men into becoming men and becoming better men in society, I think it helps the overall compass of our culture and the issues that we're facing in our society. And so I've always believed in that. Wherever I coached, building those genuine relationships with those guys, establishing that trust, and then they have some accountability with that as well, right? Holding them accountable for their actions on and off the field and how we're all interconnected and what you do off the field. You may think, well, coach, this is my personal time. Nah. That affects not only your teammates, it affects your family, and we have to learn and mature from that way. And so just continue to instill life lessons and helping build these relationships. That's the best way I know how to do it. And it's just, you know, as an African-American male, regardless of the ethnicity of the player I'm coaching, my goal is to help them become a better man, regardless. Yeah.
We got time for one more, Jacques.
Hey, Coach. Jacques Doucet from WAAP-TV here in Baton Rouge. Very nice to meet you. Enjoyed listening to you today, Coach.
Thank you.
I know you're not from Louisiana, but this almost looks like the Louisiana dream, right? You're coaching at Franklin and Generette roughly 20 years ago, and now you're the defensive coordinator at LSU. What do you remember about your times at those high schools? And, I mean, how crazy is it that you are where you are now?
I learned a lot. I learned a lot. One, I learned because, you know, I was coming from the north, and I came down here to Nicholls State initially. I was over there coaching with Darryl Day and Coach Jay Thomas, you know, two LSU alum. And I learned a lot just in terms of dealing with the players. To me, Louisiana is important to me because that's where I grew into my coaching personality. You know, as a very young coach, at the time when I came to Louisiana, I'd only been coaching for a year out of college. I did a GA job at Lenoir Ryan College. And so you're still trying to find your own. And being in Louisiana, the mentors that I was around, Coach Zeb Simon, at Generette High School, you know, like I said, Darryl Day and Jay Thomas, they gave you the confidence. They gave me the confidence to be who you are, right? Don't try to be anyone else. Don't be anyone else because the players are going to see through if you're really genuine or not. And giving a coach that confidence at an early age, early in his career, just was the world to me. And then it gave me more confidence to learn how to deal with different types of players, right, from all different backgrounds and nationalities. And so I think that experience helped groom and set the foundation to who I am today as a coach and the process that we're on, the journey that we're on.
Awesome. We appreciate the time.
Thank you.